Chiropractic versus medicine. What's the difference? I'm going to tell you. Hey, I'm Dr. Ekberg with Wellness for Life. And if you'd like to truly master health by understanding how the body really works, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you don't miss anything. So there are many different ways of comparing healthcare, different modalities of healthcare or treatment. So we're going to look at one that you probably haven't thought of previously. In chiropractic, we deal with trying to rebuild health primarily. And in medicine, they primarily deal with treating symptoms. And both of these are perfectly fine, because in an emergency, you should be very, very grateful that there's some skilled medical doctors around. But if you have a functional imbalance, then there's not a whole lot that they can do for you. Whereas in chiropractic, it is more about rebuilding. So you could think of these as, this is the fire department, this is emergency, and this is more like a carpenter or a landscaper or someone is trying to rebuild and create something. So one isn't bad or wrong, it's just they're for different things. So first I want to talk about, what is life? What is it that makes something alive? What is it that we can measure from something that is alive that we can't measure from something that is dead? And the answer is signals. Everything that is alive has an ability to receive and process and interpret and produce signals. That's what makes something alive. From the little single cellular creature all the way up to humans with somewhere around 40, 50 trillion cells, incredible complexity. But the way that this life is expressed is through signals. And the more of the appropriate signals that we have, the better that life can be expressed, the more vitality we have. So when you move, you are creating signals. When you think, you're creating signals. When you perceive something, you first have to receive signals and then process and then create an output. That's what perception is. When you talk, you have to create signals. And maybe most importantly, when you feel good, in order to feel good, you have to create a lot of signals. And let's talk about that one for a little bit. So your brain processes everything about you, and no one knows exactly how many signals per second, but just to, like a ballpark, they've estimated it processes about 1 billion bits of information every second. That's a lot of information. So that information is coming in through the spinal cord, up through the brainstem and into the frontal lobe. And the frontal lobe processes this information, and then it responds and sends signals out in response to the information it received. And here's the key to understanding what we're going to talk about, that the frontal lobe has mostly inhibitory action. That means, for the most part, it turns things off. So it gets a signal in and it turns it off. It negates that signal. And that is how the brain creates balance and experience. So when you have a negative thought and the brain needs to do away with that, the better frontal lobe activity you have, the better you can inhibit that thought. If you have pain, a little bit of pain is good, because if the pain is there so that you don't hurt yourself, so that you can detect dangerous situations. But if you have excessive pain, the brain needs to be able to inhibit and dampen and turn that pain down. So somewhere around 80 to 90% of what the brain does is to turn things off, those its inhibitory signals. So life is signals, and the brain processes all those signals. So in this perspective, what's the difference between chiropractic and medicine? And why should we understand this? Why should we be very, very concerned? Because chiropractic is what's called a receptor-based therapy. That means we stimulate receptors. We put pressure on receptors. We activate motion receptors. We activate stretch receptors in muscle spindles and joints, mechanoreceptors in joint capsules. So in doing this, we send very large amounts of specific signals to the brain. We activate the brain so the brain can create more signals. And in order for us to feel good, we have to turn off a bunch of signals. So this is why people in meditation, the people who report, and I can attest to this as well, that when you find that highest state of meditation, you are supremely happy, you're blissful. And in that state, you have a higher activity in that frontal lobe than any other state. And in that state, the frontal lobe turns off more stuff than any other time, and that's why you feel so good. So in order to feel good, you need to create lots and lots of signals. In chiropractic, they actually, through this receptor stimulation, we increase signals in the body. Okay? And here is where the biggest difference in medicine comes in. Medication, by definition, is designed to block signals. It reduces the amount of signaling in the body. It interferes with signals in the body. So in an emergency, that's not a bad thing. If you're a burn victim, if you broke a bone, you're in so much pain, you just want that pain gone. And cutting off that signal in that crisis can make you much, much more comfortable. But long term, this mechanism is devastating. It interferes with health. It reduces your vitality. It reduces the expression of health. So that's why it's so critical to understand the difference between increasing signals and decreasing signals. Understanding the difference between health and crisis management. Medicine is great at crisis management. Let's have them do that. Let's hope they get better and better at it. But let's take charge of our health by understanding that it's about signals, it's about filling in all the little pieces of a healthy lifestyle, of eating better, of moving better, of thinking and feeling better. That's how you create health. So again, to put it in the simplest possible term, the difference between chiropractic and medicine is that one increases signals and the other decreases signals. If you enjoy this sort of content, make sure that you subscribe and hit that notification bell. And please share this information with as many people as you can, because this channel is all about saving lives. And the earlier in life you start, the better off you are. Don't wait till you already have a symptom. Then you already are far down the slippery slope of degeneration. So again, share this content. And thanks for watching.